Dear students, very good morning. I am fine. I think all are fine. I hope all are your friends, your family members and your relatives all are fine. Dear students, let me come to the unit number 6. Unit number 6. Applications of vector algebra. Applications of vector algebra. In the previous classes, 11th standard, you know that we discussed the various types of vectors, examples, like vectors, unlike vectors, the vectors, equal vectors, position vectors, zero vector, null vector, like this. We know that unit vector. We know that so many types of vectors, and we discuss in brief in 11th standard. We discuss the vectors in brief in 11th standard. And also we know that the vectors represent, usually the vectors represent, if suppose a A vector, if the point A, it is a point A, it is a point B. The vector going like this, we represent the vectors as A vector like this, A vector. And its components may be I, J, K, unit vectors may be represented as a I vector, J vector, K vector like this. So we will take down the example, if A vector equal to 3i cap, plus 4j cap plus 5k cap. Some of them where they represent as a vector equal to 3i vector plus 4j vector plus 5k vector. It is also both are same. Both are same. Okay. Listen here. It is, let us consider it is a one of the vector. In the previous classes, 11th standard, we know that the sum of the vectors, sum of two vectors, sum of the two vectors and subtraction of two vectors, difference of two vectors, subtraction of the two vectors or difference of two vectors, at the multiplication of a vector with a scalar, multiplication of a vector with a scalar. Okay. And that way, in this 12th standard, we discuss about the dot product and cross product of two vectors. It is a product of two vectors. In this topic, we discuss about the product of vectors. The product of two vectors is defined into two types. One is dot product. Dot product or scalar product of two vectors. Scalar product of two vectors. Scalar product of two vectors. If suppose A vector is any vector and B vector is another own vector, then the dot product of two vectors can be represented as A vector dot B vector. A vector dot B vector equal to modulus of A vector, modulus of B vector into cos theta. A vector dot B vector equal to modulus of A vector, modulus of B vector into cos theta. At the same time, cross product. Cross product or vector product. Cross product or vector product of two vectors. Let us consider A vector and B vector be any two vectors. And its cross product, A vector cross B vector. A vector cross B vector. Know the difference between them. It is a dot. It is a cross. We say it is a dot product or scalar product. It is a dot product. It is a cross product or vector product. That is, modulus of A vector, modulus of B vector, sine theta into n cap, sine theta into n cap. So, but listen here. This is the main concept in this exercise. Not for in this exercise. In the 12th standard, we discuss about the main concept, these two concepts we using the throughout that chapter. A vector dot B vector equal to modulus of A vector modulus of B vector into cos theta. At the same time, vector product that A vector cross B vector, say this is A vector cross B vector equal to modulus of A vector modulus of B vector sin theta into n cap. Okay, if I listen here, what is it here? Say to be a scalar product. That is a two vectors product. If the vector product of two vectors, answer is a one of the scalar, is scalar. So it is said to be as a scalar product or dot product. If it, A vector is one vector, B vector is one vector, then cross product of these two vectors is another one vector. So we said to be it is a vector product. So it is said to be as a vector product. Okay. Let us assume that. Let us take down. A vector equal to A1 I vector. I will put it as A1 I vector or A1 I cap plus B1 J cap plus C1 K cap and B vector equal to A2 I cap plus B2 J cap plus C2 K cap. Then the vector product of two vectors and dot product of two vectors can be defined as, if A vector dot B vector equal to, it is a dot product, A vector dot B vector equal to A1 I vector plus B1 J vector J cap plus C1 K cap into A2 I cap plus B2 J cap plus C2 K cap. Then the values becomes multiplication. We know that I cap into dot product of I cap equal to J cap dot J cap equal to K cap dot K cap equal to 1. And also I dot J equal to J dot K equal to I dot K equal to 0. Equal to 0. By using that concept here, A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2. This is a vector A vector dot B vector. A vector dot B vector. Then, vector product A vector cross B vector equal to A vector cross B vector equal to I vector, J vector, K vector. Put it as a determinant symbol for that. 3 by 3 determinants. The first one, A vector. A vector represents as A1, B1, C1. We put it as a first A1, B1, C1. Second row, finished. And then third row, A2, B2, C2. Then expand this. We expand this. I vector equal to, what is it here? I vector equal to B1, C2 minus B2, C1. Minus J vector into A1 C2 minus A2 C1 plus K vector into A1 B2 minus A2 B1. So that is we represent as B1 C2 minus B2 C1 into I vector minus A1 C2 minus A2 C1 into J vector plus A1 B2 minus A2 B1 into K vector. This is a cross product of two vectors or vector product of two vectors. Okay, then we need to find that angle between the vectors. We know that if A vector dot B vector equal to modulus of A vector and modulus of B vector into cos theta, we know that. So we exchange these values here. A vector dot B vector dot modulus of A vector modulus of B vector equal to cos theta. Then we are able to write like this, theta equal to cos inverse of, theta equal to cos inverse of A vector dot B vector by modulus of A vector modulus of B vector. Similarly, we using the cross product formula also. In the cross product formula, sin theta equal to modulus of A vector cross B vector divided by modulus of A vector modulus of B vector. Modulus of A vector cross B vector by modulus of A vector into modulus of B vector. Next, come to the exercise 6.1, sum number 9. Prove by vector method. Prove by vector method. Cos alpha minus beta equal to cos alpha cos beta plus sin alpha sin beta. This is a one of the very important problem in this unit, vector algebra. This is a frequently asking 5 mark question in annual examination. There's another four, there are four types of questions are there. One of the question is cos alpha minus beta, cos alpha plus beta, sin alpha minus beta, sin alpha plus beta. There are four types of formulas are there. Here, first of all, we need to prove that cos alpha minus beta equal to cos alpha cos beta plus sin alpha sin beta. The equation already we proved by trigonometry in the previous class. That is 11th standard, we proved that the equation by applying the values alpha equal to any angle 30 degree, 45 degree like this. But here, we need to prove that here the problem in vector method. Vector method. Let us consider a unit circle. It is the origin. It is the x-axis. It is the x-axis. It is the y-axis. It is the x-axis. I vector along on x-axis. J vector on y-axis. J vector on y-axis. Simply write it like this. I vector on x-axis. J vector on y-axis. Let us take down any point P on it. Let us assume that the point is a cos alpha comma sin alpha. Let us assume the point is a cos alpha and sin alpha. Join OP with an angle OX is alpha. Okay. Take any point P. Cos alpha comma sin alpha with OP. Angle XOP equal to alpha. Okay. Draw PM perpendicular to OX. Then find the values of OP vector. OP vector equal to OM I vector plus MPJ vector. OM I vector plus MPJ vector. That the values becomes cos alpha I vector plus sin alpha J vector. That is the vector OP vector. Let us consider the vector as a A vector. Okay, A vector. And then take down the next to another one point Q. Assume the point as cos beta comma sin beta. Join it. So therefore, consider the point Q. Cos beta comma sin beta with an angle beta. So therefore, with an angle XOQ equal to beta. Similarly, draw the perpendicular QN. M, already we put it as a M. Here N. QN perpendicular to OX. Then OQ vector. It is unknown vector. Does it know the vector? So we go this side. That is ON I vector. ON distance. The vector is I vector. NQ into J vector. The side is vector direction is J vector. Here the vector direction is I vector. So that is cos B I vector plus sin B J vector. Here it is represented as a unit circle. Already I told you it is a unit circle. So what is it here? That is OP vector. Modulus of OP vector equal to modulus of OQ vector is always equal. You know, because it is a radius. It is a radius. Both OP and OQ are radius. Both OP and OQ are radius. Let us take down equation 1 and 2. By multiplication of vector products or dot products. Using here dot product. Okay. No need to using here vector product. So that is OP vector dot OQ vector equal to, by the definition, definition says here OP vector OQ vector into cos, the angle between the two vectors, it is a P, that is OP vector, this is a OQ vector. The angle between these two vectors is, here the total angle is alpha. It, that angle is beta, so the remaining angle alpha minus beta. Remaining angle is alpha minus beta. So that is cos alpha minus beta. OP vector dot OQ vector equal to modulus of OP, modulus of OQ into cos alpha minus beta. That is 1 into 1 cos alpha minus beta. That is OP vector dot OQ vector equal to cos alpha minus beta. Let us take down, it is equation number 3. By then, from equation 1 and 2, then OP vector dot OQ vector equal to cos alpha I vector plus sin alpha J vector into cos beta I vector plus sin beta into J vector. Then multiply this cos alpha cos beta plus sin alpha sin beta. So but therefore here OP vector dot OQ vector. Take down equation number 4. By equation 3 equal to 4, we got it here cos alpha minus beta equal to cos alpha cos beta plus sin alpha sin beta. Okay, listen here. I repeat again, students. Listen clearly, watch the given equation, listen here. Prove by vector method. Cos alpha minus beta equal to cos alpha cos beta plus sin alpha sin beta. Sin alpha sin beta. Let us consider a unit circle. Unit circle means the radius of the circle is a 1 unit. The radius of the circle is a 1 unit. So what is it here? Let us assume that the I vector, it is a x-axis, it is a y-axis, it is x-axis and it is a y-axis. I vector on x-axis, I vector on x-axis, j vector on y-axis. Take any point P, that is a point P, cos alpha comma sin alpha. At the same time, I take down another one point Q, cos beta and sin beta. So first of all, the cos alpha and sin alpha, the point P, with an angle alpha with the XOP. The angle XOP equal to alpha. Then draw PM perpendicular to OX. OX. So that is the OP vector. We need to find the values of OP vector. OP vector. OP is the unknown values. So let us know that OM. OM, we know that. OM is the distance. That is cos alpha distance. And this side is I vector. Okay. And then here sin alpha. Then sin alpha. This distance is sin alpha. Direction is J vector. One small example I gave here. If suppose this is the direct route for Chennai to Thiruvannamalai, means we go to east towards east 50 kilometers up to Dindivanam and we take down the left towards north, directly you reaches the Chennai. Okay, are you understand or not? Towards, that is how many distance there? Up to Dindivanam we take down the towards east. After you reaches Dindivanam, you take left, proceed towards north. Okay, this is the formula. So by this is a direct way. Let us consider it is an air way. OP vector, this is a Thiruvannamalai, this is a Chennai. It is a direct way, that is an air way. But is the root, our root is OM plus MP. OM plus MP. So OM direction is OM. distance that is cos alpha, that is Dindivanam is distance around 60 kilometers. 60 kilometers it is go to eastwards. After that take left turn and then you are going proceed around 120 kilometers towards north. Understand? Are you understand or not? Okay. If suppose you pass 60 kilometers directly, you go to Pondicherry. Okay. You remember that. That is the direction is in a must in the vectors. Direction is must in the vectors. So that is OP vector equal to OM I vector or OP IM I vector. Note if you proceed like this or otherwise OP vector equal to OM I cap plus MP J cap. Okay. Anyhow, we write it like this. Either cap or vector. Okay. OP vector equal to cos alpha I vector plus sin alpha J vector. Then similarly, Q equal to cos beta, comma sin beta. Then we take down the values like this. We got it. OP vector dot OR vector equal to OP modulus of OQ cos alpha minus beta. That OP vector equal to 1. That is modulus of OP vector. And modulus of OQ vector is unit vectors. So that the values is 1. Modulus values is 1. So that is OP vector dot OQ vector equal to cos alpha minus beta. Similarly, by using that ordinary multiplication of two vectors by dot product. It is a definition. It is a expansion of the dot product. So we got it the values like this. This is a Hence proved. Next, another one formula.